Welcome back. So today we are going to just discuss about pasteurization and types of this method. Already if you have watched my video on why it is important to pasteurize milk, then you know the importance of pasteurization, and I hope you had watched that video. If not, then you can check out that video on my channel. Okay, so now I will not be discussing about what is the importance of pasteurization. So quickly we will start with today's topic. So pasteurization is process named after scientist Louis Pasteur, as he is the one who invented this process. So the process applies heat to destroy pathogens in food like milk. Okay, that is the principle. So for dairy industry, the term pasteurization, pasteurized, or similar terms means the process of heating every particle of milk or milk product in properly designed and operated equipment under given temperature and time. Okay, so this is the basic definition, and today we are going to discuss three types, that is LTH, HTST and UHT. Okay, so these are two types, and let's start with the first, that is low temperature holding, or also known as VAT pasteurization, holding system, batch process pasteurization, or holder process, or LTLT, that is low temperature long time process. Okay, so initially it was designed in such a way that milk was exposed to temperature of 60 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes. But it was observed that this temperature does not destroy Mycobacterium tuberculosis and Coxsella burnetii. Okay, these are pathogens which are likely to be transmitted from raw milk. Correct? So the aim or the purpose of pasteurization is not getting completed here. So again, the process was modified and milk was exposed to temperature of 61.7 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. Okay, so you can see from 60 degrees Celsius, the temperature was increased to 61.7 degrees Celsius, and time from 20 minutes to 30 minutes. So this condition could destroy only M. tuberculosis, that is Mycobacterium tuberculosis, but not Coxsella burnetii. Okay, so again, the method was modified where milk was exposed at 62.8 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes, and this was the condition which was we can say ideal, as it could destroy both Mycobacterium tuberculosis and Coxsella burnetii. Okay, so the purpose is getting completed, or we can achieve our aim here. So this was the condition which was decided to apply or to use in case of low temperature holding. Okay, so milk is heated in a vessel called vat, which it is kind you can say like fermenter. It is a vessel which is used to hold milk. It is equipped with a jacket, steam through which steam or hot water having temperature of 62.8 degrees Celsius is circulated through the jacket for 30 minutes. So in this way, the heat exchange happens through hot water or steam to the milk. Okay, and this is the way the milk gets heated, and then after 30 minutes, then milk is cooled rapidly to 7 degrees Celsius or 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, so the rapid cooling of milk is also important in pasteurization. So that was the first method. Then second is high temperature short time, which is written as HTST. Okay, so in this method, heating of milk is done at 71.7 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds. This method reduces microbial load up to 99%, and that is the reason mostly this method is widely used. Unlike LTH, that is low temperature holding, this method is continuous, and therefore equipment or pasteurizer used for this method is known as continuous flow pasteurizer. Okay, so there are actually two types of flow pasteurizer: tubular heater, which is again divided as internal tubular heater or external tubular heater, and second is plate heat exchanger. So here we are first going to discuss about internal tubular heater. Okay, so in this type, there are multiple sets of several tubes which are arranged in definite manner. In every set, one tube is placed within another. Okay, so you can see the outer tube will have hot water and the inner tube will have milk, and this is the way where the heat exchange is going to happen from hot water to the milk. Okay, so there are multiple such sets arranged, and what happens in the outermost tube, here you can see there is the hot water, so that is the outermost tube, which acts like a jacket, which has hot water or steam, which has the temperature of 71.7 degrees Celsius flowing in one direction. So you can see the direction of hot water is opposite, and the innermost tube has milk which flows in opposite direction of that of the hot water. So you can see further here, if there are multiple sets arranged, then milk is going to flow in this direction, but hot water is going to flow in opposite direction. Okay, so why the flow is important? Because we also have to maintain the temperature, right? After the heat is exchanged from milk and hot water, from hot water to milk, it may happen that the hot water it gets, or the temperature is dropped. Okay, so to avoid that, the hot water is kept in continuous circulation, and even milk also. So this is the way, or this is one type of internal tubular heater. Okay, next is external tubular heater. Same sets are there, same arrangement is there, but the difference here is now milk is in the outer tube and the hot water is the into the inner tube. Okay, so again the directions are opposite. Milk will flow towards other direction and hot water to the other. So design of this pasteurizer is same as that of internal tubular heater. However, the position of milk and that of the hot water or steam having temperature of 71.7 degrees Celsius is opposite. So milk is now flowing through outer tube and hot water is flowing through the inner tube. Okay, so the flow directions of both are in opposite directions, correct? So just the placement of milk and hot water is opposite. That is the difference in the internal tubular heater and external tubular heater. Why external? Because milk is what we need to heat, and that is here in the external. Okay, in case of internal, milk was placed in the inner tube. In case of external, milk is kept, or milk is there in the outermost tube. That is the difference. The next is about plate heat exchanger. In this type of pasteurization, several thin metal plates are arranged in a compact manner, leaving fine gaps between every two consecutive plates. You can see these are some plates which are arranged in compact manner, which has fine gaps between them. Okay, so raw milk to be pasteurized is allowed to enter in from one point. You can see the blue arrow here is actually the milk. Okay, so it will flow in like this direction. Okay, and hot water or steam is allowed to enter through the opposite end. So this was the product entry, and another plate will have heat medium entering through it. Okay, so this is the way the milk passes through it, through these metal plates. The exchange of heat takes place between hot water and milk, or in case hot steam and milk, and as a result, pasteurized milk coming out of the pasteurizer is more hot than that of the hot water leaving pasteurizer. Why this is? This is because the heat exchange has taken place, and that is the result. Now milk is pasteurized and it is having high temperatures than that of the hot water or steam. This hot pressure, this hot pasteurized milk is introduced into another similar unit to allow transfer of heat from milk to water. Okay, so now this is the another case where again the milk is passed through another similar unit, from where the transfer of heat will happen from milk to the water. Why? Because this method becomes regenerative type, in which cost of heating water is substantially reduced. Okay, so now again heat transfer has happened and you have hot water, and same hot water can be used again to the first unit to pasteurize milk. Okay, so that is about the plate heat exchanger. Here you can see in a diagram, the blue lines, they are actually products here, which means milk. Okay, so you can see how it flows. So this is actually the plate heat exchanger. Okay, again you can see there is a regenerative cooling type, right? Hot water system is there. Okay, so heating is done, right? This is the feed pump, okay, which is going to the, again, means the pasteurized milk is again going towards the homogenizer. Even the cream is getting separated, right? And again, that is passed to the holding tube, okay? So again, it will get, here it will get pasteurized, here it will get, again, exchange the heat will exchange with the water. So regenerative cooling is done here again, okay? So that is how the plate heat exchanger works. So here are some advantages and disadvantages of HTST. So advantages are like lower initial cost, then less floor space is required, then milk loss is reduced, right? Then even development of thermophiles is not a problem. Automatic precision controls ensure proper pasteurization. These are some advantages, while disadvantages are like the system is not well adapted to handling small quantities of liquid milk products, right? Then gaskets required constant attention for possible damage and lack of sanitization. Margin of safety in product sanitary control are now narrow, that automatic control precision instruments are required in its operation. Then accumulation of milk stones in the heating section may happen, and you need to monitor that as well. So these are some advantages and disadvantages. As I say, there are methods which has, each method has advantage and disadvantage. Okay, so you need to be prepared for the disadvantages or the limitations of this method as well. Okay, so if you get a question, then for HTST, then you can add these points, advantages and disadvantages. Then third is ultra high temperatures. So any method of pasteurization of milk using temperatures between 130 to 150 degrees Celsius is known as pasteurization at ultra high temperature. Why? Because this is actually very high temperature, right? We use 71.7 degrees Celsius for HTST, right? And 62.8 for LHT. So 130 and 150 degrees Celsius is too much. So it is named as ultra high temperature. Generally in this method, milk is heated at 137.8 degrees Celsius per 1 second, okay? So the exposure is very, very less to these high temperatures. This heat treatment can be carried out with the help of direct heating or with the help of indirect heating. So there are two types here again. So steam, we will study first direct heating or direct heating. So steam having desired temperature is injected into milk. Alternatively, the raw milk will be introduced to the chamber which holds the steam having temperatures of 137.8 degrees Celsius. Okay, so there are two ways you can introduce steam to the milk, or raw milk is introduced to the chamber which holds the steam. So what will happen? Within few minutes, this steam will condense, forming water. Okay, so the volume of milk increases, and therefore extra volume of water is removed by evaporating pasteurized milk under vacuum. Okay, so this is one way. Another way is indirect heating, in which in this method milk is heated to desired temperatures with the help of surface heat exchanger, or preferably with the help of corrugated plate heat exchanger, which are heated electrically. Okay, so here you will not find any problem like condensation of water. Okay, then again you have to evaporate that. So this is time consuming and bit expensive with compared to the indirect heating. Okay, so again I am discussing this here because many students which refer to my channel, they have some questions, and if you get this kind of question in your exam, like write a short note on ultra high temperatures, then you should mention these types. There are advantages and disadvantages also. Okay, so let's see that. Advantages of UHT, that is ultra high temperatures, are prolonged shelf life as compared to the milk processed by LTH or HTST method. Why this is? Because we are exposing milk to very high temperatures, and this ensures that there are no microorganisms present, so it will increase or it will help in prolonged shelf life. Okay, and as the shelf life is prolonged, there is no requirement of refrigeration facility. Therefore, milk can be stored at room temperatures as well. So even transportation becomes more convenient as you don't need any refrigeration. Supply of milk can be ensured to these sites where which are difficult to access. Okay, say they are in very remote areas, or transportation is difficult, or you can say more time is required to reach at such sites. So there, such UHT treated milk, pasteurized milk, can be supplied. Disadvantages are organoleptic properties of milk are likely to be changed. For example, flavor or the taste of milk may be altered. Nutritive value of milk is slightly deteriorated due to the loss of thermolabile vitamins. Okay, so these are some advantages and disadvantages of ultra high temperature method of pasteurization. Okay, so from exam point of view, I think these three methods are sufficient. Okay, so you can refer to other methods as well. On Google, you can read some articles. There are some websites and you can go through them. Okay, if you need more than some other methods, more than these three. Okay, so thank you for watching my videos. Do like, share and subscribe to my channel, and also recommend my videos and my channel to your friend. Okay, thank you for watching and thank you for your support. Hope you are enjoying. All the best.